Today, I'll be explaining to you what is eccentric contraction. The three factors on how eccentric contraction facilitates tendon healing and the general guideline to commence a eccentric exercise program. Hi, I'm Fred with Physio Explain, where we help you understand medical conditions and learn self-management strategies. I hope you find this video helpful. If it does, make sure to smash that like button so it turns blue. And now, let's jump into it. Eccentric contraction involves the muscle contracting while lengthening. To eccentrically contract my bicep muscle, I can hold onto weight and lower my arm slowly. In this example, my biceps is contracting but lengthening at the same time. In terms of rehabilitation, physiotherapists often prescribe eccentric exercise to help us increase our muscle strength and muscle length. In particular, eccentric exercise is often used in the management of chronic tendinopathy. There are increasing evidence that eccentric exercise can significantly reduce pain and facilitate tissue healing in people with Achilles and patellar tendinopathy and tennis elbow. The benefit can be attributed to three factors. First, with increasing our muscle strength, we can more easily tolerate the amount of loading placed on our tendons during daily activity. Second, eccentric exercise may facilitate tendon remodeling by promoting collagen fiber formation within our injured tendon. Third, eccentric exercise may promote an increase in our muscle length, and this increase in our muscle length will result in reduced loading placed on our tendon during movement. To support the theory, in 2015, Timmons and colleagues found a short muscle length and reduced eccentric knee flexor strengths significantly increase the risk of a hamstring strain injury. In conclusion, with longer muscle length and increased eccentric muscle strengths, we can significantly reduce the recurrence of a hamstring strain injury. The general guideline to eccentric resistance exercise is we want to start eccentric exercise at a low intensity and progressively increase the level of intensity. By doing this, we can prevent injury from excessive loading and also reduce the likelihood of us experiencing this delayed onset muscle soreness. Generally speaking, our goal is to perform 3 sets of 15 repetitions, and we want to do the same routine every once or twice per day for 12 weeks. Finally, it's recommended to perform a set of isometric exercise before eccentric exercise, as this will help us reduce pain and allow us to generate a higher muscular contraction during eccentric exercise. And by doing this, we can also build up more muscle strength. If you like the content from today's video, feel free to subscribe by clicking the red button below. And once again, thank you for watching. I will see you next time.